started hearing coronavirus, but I'm bringing it up just a little bit later because I'm tired of seeing it. I'm tired of talking about it. Like, we get it, corona, like, damn. So, our first little thing that we're going to start doing is music alert, music review, which means I either talk about the latest big hit, the latest big album, whatever. Usually my choice of music. I don't know if people would like the same type of music that I do, but yeah. So Williams Live is crazy, but that's celebrity gossip. We'll get into that in a minute. So anyways, Rihanna's new song, right? Okay, my girl been gone for some years. She was focused on the makeup, the fashion, and I'm like, girl, where's the music? Okay, where's the music? We need that, like, right now. Okay, and this girl just sings the chorus and call it a day. Like, girl, we was waiting on you for some years to drop some music, and you just say, yeah.
This is like, leave it on. This is like, exactly.
If I'm being so honest, because I was like, okay, this girl finna have a burst. You know, she finna, that's my Pisces sus. Like, I was just like, she finna be bomb. And then she drops the bomb of just singing the chorus. And I'm like, girl, like, it was fire. But then I was just like, girl. And I've been trying to get into Brent. People been telling me to get into him. And I'm just like, I can't. Like, I don't know what it is. Like, I vibe to him with certain songs, but a lot of them I just be like, skip. Like, I don't know, like, I'm not a hater of Brent. I'm just, you know, I like some of his songs off that album. I'm just catching people up on, like, old albums that have been out for a minute, but also just a music review. So yeah, I try to listen to his new album and I'm not up for the lot. I didn't even like it. I only like three songs. I know that makes me like a hater or something. I'm not. He's a dope artist, just not for me. Like I said, Janae's, it was here. You know, we had that Summer Walker, and then Janae was just like, boom, you know? She was like, I'm the bomb. Well, no, they're not in competition, but, you know. Yeah. Yeah, like, I feel like people can connect to him, like, who went through a lot. I went through a lot, too, but not exposing my business, but I don't know, like, I tried to get into him, but I just couldn't. Like, I was just like, I don't know. So, yeah. That is some of the new music that I have heard. I don't know about rappers because I don't really listen to them, if I'm being so honest, okay? But, yeah. All right, so now we're going to go into celebrity tea, okay? Not really tea, just some stuff that I found interesting. So, we're going to talk about B-Simone and the baby. Okay, like, I know that's the baby because those were his tats. Like, he shows them off a little bit. So, I'm like, oh, she got the baby. And she was in his live talking about Call Me when he was all up on Raven. Mind you, Raven's a whole lesbian. She don't want him. Like, and he weird for that. I'm not going to lie. Off of her wanting a boyfriend. Now, some people would say, and I feel like she could get any man, like, and I feel like, you know, most of it is fake when she's like, I don't want a boyfriend, like, probably most of all, she don't want one, or two, she already got one, but she just doing it for money. But all I'm saying with that is like, how do we feel about that? Because does that make her look desperate? But then it's like the concept of equality, like, with women, like, we can't shoot our shot. But men don't even shoot their shot when they're supposed to. Like, not like in the 90s and 80s, where they was like, oh, if it is love, oh, why? Well, hey, no, but I'm just saying, like, it seems like it's a desperate move for girls to shoot their shot. But it's like, no, it's just like, I think you fine just the way you think I'm fine. And I'm just like, what's popping? What's up? You know, because you're not saying nothing, so I'm not finna miss an opportunity. What if you're my soulmate? Okay? But a lot of people do call her desperate because, like I said, she basically made her whole career of her wanting a boyfriend. And honestly, she's not even. At first she was, but then I'm like, okay. And the baby has not been that fine. I'm sorry. He has not. Like, I look at him and I'm just like, your smile is very nice, but everything else, like, no. And I don't like the fact that people are accepting his apology. Well, not accepting his, well, okay, let me say my words. I don't like the fact that people are accepting his apology for smacking that woman. But, like, people are still on Chris Brown for hitting Rihanna. Like, if you think about, like, okay, first of all, no one should put their hands on anyone. But I'm just saying, like, I don't know, like, y'all all on Chris Brown for doing what he gotta do, for, you know, I guess defending himself, even though it was so wrong that he beat her up. And then it's just like, the baby did the same thing, and you're like, oh, it's okay, oh, it's not that big of a deal. He smacked the F out of her, like, it looked like her wig just went, you know, slid. And everyone forgave him. So I'm just like, y'all need to keep that same energy. And back to what all this relates to is equality in this generation, okay? If you get what I'm saying. Like, women, we never had equality, especially as Black women. Never had it. So, but all I'm trying to say is that people don't have the same standards for women as they do men in some cases, and then some men don't, you know, like, it's just different stuff. Like, okay, let me give a fair example. Okay, so when I'm just saying, when all those kids went missing, no one really cared, especially the Black women, no one cared. But if you had to weigh it out, there was Black men missing, no one really ever really talked about that. It was really just the Black women. It was kind of equal with that, actually. Never mind, they both talked about. And all these celebrities, man, like, you know what? I'm gonna just go on the celebrity talk. Because all these celebrities, man, they be talking about stay safe, wash your hands, quarantine, da, da, da. But they're living their best life in their 12-story mansion and have a pool inside, have video games. Like, all you can't do is what? Go perform? Which requires a workout. But it's like, you got gyms. Like, for us middle class poor people, we don't have none of that. We gotta be bored. We gotta stay in the house while other people just get to celebrate. And they don't even donate one type, like, to help. All they do is make a post. Like, what is that supposed to do? Y'all have so much money, but y'all not helping nobody. It's these nurses and doctors that are actually helping us to cure this coronavirus. And that goes into my next topic, coronavirus. I'm so glad nobody's in this live, because I keep on popping topic. I'm in here by myself. Don't need nobody else. This is episode one of the quarantine night. Ooh, episode one of the quarantine night. You know what? It's okay. At least I'm trying. So, anyways, you know what? Might as well talk about the coronavirus. Okay, so this coronavirus, man, is not the move. Like, it's really not the move, because it's like, we're stuck in the house, and some people aren't in good circumstances. Like, they're like, just stay at home, da, da, da. But some people actually need to go out and be with their friends. Some people actually need the school to be, like, their gateway to get out of a situation that they were in. And that's the sad part. Like, you know, they're stuck in that situation. But here are some benefits to the coronavirus. If you live in the ghetto, most likely your streets are getting cleaned down. Like, I walked down 23rd, 25th, and the streets were clean. Like, so clean. I was just like, it hasn't been like this. I never seen the streets like this at all, man. So streets are getting clean, people are getting taken care of. There's barely any homeless people now. I mean, there are homeless people, but like hotels have opened up to where they can stay there, or certain motels. That's the good thing. That should have been freaking happening, but you know, nobody cares. Then also global warming's dying down, because if y'all remember, we had really bad global warming last year with all the fires and all that, man. And also with the corona, like, the other benefit is that you're forced to focus on yourself. Now, some say that's not a good thing, some say that's a good thing. I just feel like it's a good thing because you're seeing what other talents you could do. You're trying to discover new stuff about yourself. You're trying to maybe love yourself more. Like, you're trying to do everything in your power to keep your mentality sustained. But also, like, you know, like, we're finding ourselves, especially for us young people. Like, I get it, like, we still have a lot of life to live, hopefully, if Lord willing. But, you know, we're just trying to figure everything out. But it's good that we have this self-isolation. I take it as meditation in a way, because it's like we're closed off from the world, we can't really go anywhere, and it's like everything is kind of silent around you. So it's just like meditation is really nice. So that's what how I feel about the corona. But also, I still don't like how people are going outside the house. Like, there was a whole slideshow here. It's just like, can y'all stay in the house? This is the reason why we don't go out. It's because, like, places are not fully closed, or people just don't care. It's like, bro, if you want to get out of this corona stuff, then stop going outside. Like, stop in social distance. Like, don't have more than 10 people around you. Like, how hard is that? Now we got an extra 30 days. Y'all couldn't do it for 2 weeks. Now we got to do it for an extra 30 days. So I'm going to need y'all to stay in the house. But it should have had not to this corona to help y'all learn how to wash yourselves. That is sad and disappointing. That's all I gotta say about that. Because y'all shouldn't have been washing your hands. Y'all shouldn't have been like cleaning where y'all sit at and stuff like that. Y'all shouldn't have been doing all that. But no, like, it's just the corona for y'all to realize, oh, we gotta be clean. We gotta take care of ourselves. Like, why did it take all that? Why did it take the corona to make y'all realize that? Y'all need kids. Get the man. Get the. Okay. So that is about the coronavirus, and I already talked about the baby and me as well. But I also want to talk about how we lost dating in this generation. Okay. So what I mean by that is that we don't date to marry anymore. I get it, we're young and stuff, especially us 18 through 21 year olds, we still figuring out life. But what I'm saying is that we don't date to marry anymore, because it's just like, okay, I date because I'm bored right now, or I'm just dating her, him or her, to just have a, you know, 1 hour of a good time, if you all get what I'm saying. It's just like, it seems like this generation is only about sex. I mean, I feel like back then it was too, but I think it's just really in our face now. Like, it's really on social media. Like, and, you know, dudes are really different now. Like, maybe it's just because maybe I haven't met a good one for real, but it seems like guys don't shoot their shot anymore. And I don't know why that died down, because guys used to really be like, what's up, you know, let me talk to you, like, let me get your number, like, be respectful to girls. Shoot, Temptations used to say to a girl, be like, can I get your number? Oh, you know what I'm saying? Like, we lost that. Like, guys don't even shoot their shot no more. All they do is stare. Or if anything, it's like the really, okay, nobody's ugly. but it's really like not your type that is trying to get at you. And it's just like, no, like, and then the fine ones just be acting like bougie and bitter. But I think it's because now women are all over men now. Like, what I mean is that we put them on a higher pedestal than what they are. I mean, some men do that to women too. I just feel like we all have pride and ego now, like, or we just think that we're better than other people. And it's like, no, we're not. Like, we're all human at the end of the day. Like, you just have, I guess, a better face of what the standard is in society. So, probably got a better personality than all y'all. I'm just like, but all that says is that, I don't know, like, guys don't shoot their shot no more. And it seems like roles are reversed. Maybe it's because we're in a new society of where women are taking charge now and like are like, what's up, like, you know, like, not saying that we act like dudes, but it's just like we not finna, I don't know, like, we got dude techniques now, and I think that's kind of bad too. But you know, we still have submissiveness in a way. I think we should learn how to play the game just like these dudes, but also learn how to be submissive. A lot of females don't know how to be submissive anymore. Like, they just feel like they don't have to do anything for a man. And I'm like, that's true, but it's like, there's still, I don't know, not certain duties. It's like, I don't have to cook and clean. It's just, I do it because I'm a human being. Like, I feel like everyone should learn how to cook and clean. Like, you know? And if a man asks you that, ladies, do you know how to cook and clean? Okay, do you know how to fix the TV? Do you know how to, like, fix the pipeline in the bathroom? Do you know how to fix the toilet? Like, do you know how to fix the sink? Do you know how to fix certain stuff? Like, do you know how to be a man? You know, like, if we're really doing stereotypes, and it's really disgusting. And all that to say is, like, I don't know if roles are reversed this generation, or it's just everyone's trying to be equal. I don't know what it is. It's like, I don't mind it, but it's like, don't put me under the cap. I don't know what it is with us. And maybe that's our generation also. Like, we all play games and we all think a certain way. And like I said, men be acting like they're on a higher pedestal than what they are. Girls be doing the same thing. It's like, everyone's playing games. No one is in it for real. And it's just like, is it the social media stuff? Like, we don't know what it is, but it's just not okay. Not okay. And that goes into my other topic. Yes, I have an hour-long segment, so I will be on here forever. Get used to it. Period. Okay? And I'm gonna keep this live open so y'all can see it, because I'll just call this quarantine chat. That's what I'm calling it. Yep. I don't know if I'm posting this on YouTube though. Maybe. But anyways, so I was on Instagram, right? And I came across a story, and it said, why? No, this girl asked this guy, she was like, is it okay for girls to cheat? Or like, why do you guys act so different when a girl cheat? Like, y'all be raised to lead, but y'all want a female to take y'all back. Now, I've seen it as a good debate. Now, some men was like, because we really have feelings for men to let them in for us to cheat, or like, we're just trying to get even and it's disrespectful. But I'm like, if anything, the man is disrespectful for cheating. It's like, if he has his everything, why would he mess that up for like a 3-second intercourse? If you know what I'm saying, like, men mess up all the time and expect women to take them back and have their full trust. And it's like, how does that work? Like, how can you guys not be faithful? I just don't understand that. It's like, everybody is for everybody, unfortunately, and people be cheating, but it's just like, it's like, no one should be cheating. But I'm just saying, like, if a female cheat, I feel like she be should hold held to the same standard as a man when he cheats. But anyways, so they just feel like women can't cheat because we catch feelings or whatever, or like, you know, there's a deeper meaning behind this one cheat. And it's just like, if you cheat, I don't know, like, it's just like, if you cheat on me, I'm gonna cheat on you. Like, that's just how it works. Like, I don't know what else to tell you. Like, or not even that, I'm gonna just break up with you. Yeah. It's just, I don't know. Like, that was a good debate in my opinion. But I was just like, I don't know, people's mindset is so different now. It's just like, men could cheat, it's okay. Take the bet. They'll love you again. And I just feel like once a cheater is always a cheater. Like, I can never fully get my trust again. You know, like, I don't know how some women do it. Maybe I have to be in the predicament. But I don't know. Like, I just, I couldn't do it. But yeah, let's go back to my man rant, what I was doing. So these dudes be acting bougie now. They be acting like nobody could touch them. And it's just like, but it's like they complain. And then, no, this is this whole generation though. All the really fine people, they complain about being single, right? They all complain about it. But it's just like, there's so many people in y'all DMs wanting to give y'all the world. Back once a week. I don't know what day it will be, but once a week, quarantine stuff is like a meditation thing. I'm trying to do better. But yeah, I love my fans. I know y'all not watching me right now. It is all good. Like, y'all know I'm gonna get y'all back one day. Like, you know, it's all good. But be make sure to tune in whenever I post that I'm going live. Please, like, tune in. Because I'm lit. Like, why would you want to miss this? Okay? So, this has been Radioniy quarantine version. And I'll see ya next week. Alright? Alright. Bye, y'all.